Hi there, this is Sarah from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library. Today I'm going to show you how to use Cricut Design Space and some old plastic covers from a binder or a plastic placemat to create your own ear savers. So the first thing we're going to do is log on to Cricut Design Space. Your home page should look something like this. The next thing we're going to do is click on the plus sign for a new project. Once it opens, it should look something like this. This grid is going to be the workspace that we will be using today. Because we're going to be using a template for these ear savers, what we're going to do next is click on this little cloud at the bottom that says Upload. Once the upload screen opens, we're going to click here on the green button that says Upload Image. Next, we're going to choose Browse. And we'll navigate to where we've saved our file. I'm looking for this one right here. So I'm going to choose it and click on Open. I'll be able to link to this file as well, so you'll be able to use the same one as me. Because this is an SVG file, it will open and we won't have to do very much with it. We'll just be able to click on Save. Once you've saved it, it'll appear here in your recently uploaded images. Next, we need to click on it to highlight it. You'll notice it appears down here. And then we're going to click on Insert Images. The nice thing about this file is it's already to scale, so you won't have to play around with it too much. If you did want to make a larger or a smaller one, you can click on these little arrows in the corner, and you should be able to scale it smaller or larger. Somewhere around 7 inches wide is pretty good. So you can always go up here and just enter in 7, and that's a pretty good width. You'll notice that there's 4 different types of ear guards. You might not necessarily want to cut each one. It's up to you. You'll notice that they're over here with the little eyeballs. So you can start turning off eyeballs and you'll notice that they start disappearing. So you can just select which one you want to use today, or you can cut all 4. It's totally up to you. I think for today, I'm going to use this one. This is the one I'm going to use today. So once you have it to scale and you've selected which one you want to use, you can go up to the little green button that says Make It. Now it'll appear on a mat. It won't matter too much how it shows up like this as long as your material is wide enough and long enough that it will fit on it. So I'm going to be using the cover of an old notebook today. So it will be big enough to fit. So then you can just click on Continue. This is where things are going to get a little bit complicated. We're going to have to choose which material that we're using today. I'm going to choose plastic, this one here. So when I select it, you can actually choose the pressure setting right here. I'm going to click More. So this is how I want yours to look when you're ready to load it. This will get it to cut a little bit deeper, but we're still probably going to need a couple passes. And I'll show you how to do that momentarily on my Cricut. So I'll be back in 1 second with my Cricut all ready to go, and I'll show you the next steps. All right, welcome to my little home office workspace, everybody. So the materials I'm going to be using today is just a green sticky mat, my Cricut Explore, and then this is a binder cover or a notebook cover that I actually just cut off. You can still see my lovely writing on it from school. But it's a nice firm plastic, and it'll do well for what we need today. So the first thing that we're going to do is just place it in the corner of our Cricut mat. Just gonna smooth it down, make sure it's on there well. So as you see, I tried to get it as close to the corner as possible. Now I'm using a fairly new mat, but just to make sure that it's down properly, I'm gonna use some green painter's tape and just tape down the corners just to make sure that it's really on there because we wouldn't want it to move while it was cutting. So once your mat is taped down, you've got your plastic on there, you're going to feed the Cricut by just placing the green mat under the two little white feeder marks on either side. Once it's in there firmly, you can click on the flashing arrow button. That button will just feed the material into the Cricut. Once it's in there, the C button will start lighting up and we'll just choose this button. Now our Cricut will begin cutting our ear saber. So this plastic setting that we've chosen will actually do a couple passes on its own, but you may need to refeed it just to make sure that it cuts out cleanly. So we'll see how it does after its first round and see if we can go from there. So there you go, as you see, it did one pass, and now it's moved on to its second pass. So once the file is done cutting, this button will start flashing again for us to unfeed it. But before I do that, I'm going to check it. And as you can see, it's not popping out very well. This means I need to do another pass. So I'm not going to unfeed the mat because then if I put it in again, it might not necessarily start in the same place and we might end up just with two different cut lines. So I'm just going to click on the Cricut C again to tell it that I want to cut another time. So then it will begin its second full pass. All right, so once again, we check. Still on there pretty good, so we're gonna go again. Almost there. We're going to go pass number four. All right, so at this point, I could probably get them out comfortably, but just to make sure that it comes out nice and clean and I don't break off any of these little nodes here, I'm gonna put it through one last time. All right, so as you can see, it's coming out really easily now. So now we'll click the flashing unload button. And we can carefully remove our plastic from our mat. So now we're just going to carefully pop these out. The slower you go, the better, because you don't want to rip it. And there you have it. There's a little ear protector. So you might notice that some of it's not as clean as I would have liked, just a little couple here. It could just be that my blade's not very sharp anymore, it's kind of old. But you can always clean that up with an X-Acto knife if you really wanted to. But now when you wear this, you can just put it on the back of your head and you can hook the elastics into these instead of wrapping them around your ears. So hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully you used materials you might have kicking around your home already. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.